Inhale with Steve Ross.
Hello, welcome to Inhale. I'm Steve Ross. We're going to do some yoga. Stand up. Step the feet wide apart. Slide the hands down the back of the legs. Grab the heels or ankles. Gently pull yourself down a little bit. If you need to, you can bend the knees slightly, but if you're all right, roll the weight toward the balls of the feet somewhat. Keep the breath moving through the nose all the time. I'll take you there. I'll take you there. Then let go of the heels or ankles. Just bring the left hand to the floor, right in the middle. Right arm straight up in the air. Roll the chest open. If you want a little more twist, you can walk the left hand over toward the right foot. Roll the right chest open and look up. Change sides, right hand down, left arm up. We're gonna do a different kind of show today. We're just gonna keep doing this back and forth for an hour. That's what they wanted, that's what they're getting. Okay, bring that hand down. I lied. Roll all the way up. Step the feet together. Bring the hands together in prayer pose. It's time to party. Inhale the arms up, drop the head back. Exhale, come all the way forward. Bring the hands flat down, lift the head up. Inhale, jump or step back, top of a push-up position. Stay there. Keep the arms and legs straight. Keeping the elbows close to the ribs, sink down toward the floor. As fast as you can, apparently. When you get close, inhale and arch up. With the upward facing dog, you're on the tops of the feet, legs are straight. See if you can push the chest forward as you pull the shoulders down and back. You can drop the head back. Next time you exhale, push back into a downward facing dog. Tuck the toes under. You can walk the feet in toward the hands a little bit if you want to. Begin to sink the heels down, though, along with the chest. So you're flattening the back as much as you can. Some variations of this, they just totally relax the neck. Other variations, you kind of look toward the navel. Either way is okay. But keep the breath moving through the nose. Just holding this pose for a little while works the heart because of the position of the body. From here, raise the right leg up in the air. Push the left heel down toward the floor. If it reaches the floor, that's nice. Keep pushing it into the floor. You can extend the right heel or toe, doesn't matter. And swing the foot up. Come into a crescent pose. Stay on the ball of the back foot, straighten the back leg. Bring the arms up, the hands can be apart, or you can bring them together with the index finger up. If this is easy for you, you can drop the head back. Stop telling me to say- So serious. You guys aren't grooving yet. Maybe later. Bring the hands down to the floor. Step the foot back. Come down. And up, up dog. And push back, down dog. Left leg up in the air this time. Okay, swing it up. Other side, same thing. If this is too intense for you, you can always bend the back knee a little bit. But just feel your whole body expand and stretch in every cell, stretch in every direction as much as you can, right up to the fingertips. All right, bring the hands down. Step the foot back. Come down slow. Or whatever you're doing. Arch up, up dog. Push back, down dog. Time to wake up. Jump both feet up to the hands. Chair pose, arms up in the air. Bend the legs. Try to keep the feet, or actually ankles and feet together, knees together. Try to get the arms up high. You can drop the head back if you want. If you're dropping the head back, just to make it more exciting, try to bring the palms together. Or if you can dance like Patrick is doing, that's much more entertaining. And bring the hands down, straighten the legs. Lift the head up, jump backward, step back. Come down. And up. And back, down dog. Raise the right arm up in the air. Turn totally to the side. See if you can push the hips up high. Now, if this is too much on your wrist or elbow or shoulder, or you're unsure about it, bring the left knee down to support the weight. You can always make it harder later. But if you're here and this is nothing for you, grab the big toe of the right foot, straighten the leg up. If that's still too easy, raise the left leg at the same time. Or do push-ups on the one arm. Up to the sky. You're wrapped a little tight today. All right, come down, do a push-up. The push-up can be visualized. Do the other side. Usually is. Especially if I'm not looking. Come down, all the way, arch up, and push back, downward dog.
Oh yeah, we got church ain't going nowhere.
Jump the feet up to the hands. Roll all the way up, stretch up. Arch back a little bit. Exhale, come all the way forward. Just hang forward. We'll be right back. You're watching Oxygen Media. And we're back. So roll all the way up, stretch up. You can always arch back. Feels good too. Exhale, come forward. Hands down, head up, jump back. Or step it. Come down. Teach me And up. To express myself. Because and push back. Down. And girl, I wanna
please your teacher. Show me how to do what I do better. Teacher. Tell me everything, I won't forget you.
Raise the right leg up in the air.
Show me how to make the feeling stronger. Teacher. Show me how to make it last much longer.
Swing the foot up. Crescent pose. Keeping the back foot down on the floor, lean the upper body out over the front leg. Don't come up. Then slowly straighten the front leg. Come on up into a balanced pose. Arms either in front of you or behind you.
Show me how to do what I do better. Teacher. Tell me everything, I won't forget you. Teacher. Show me. Teacher. Show me how to make the feeling stronger.
Looks pretty cool. Bring the hands down to the floor. Leg up in the air into the standing splits. Left arm straight up in the air, right hand or fingers or fingertips on the floor. Roll the upper body open as much as you can along with the left hip. If your balance is good, you can look up. If it's really good, you can not only look up, but drop the left arm behind you and grab the inside of the standing leg, standing thigh. No takers? There's one taker. Oh, there it is. I'm surprised at you. All right, bring it down, feet together, hands down. Roll all the way up, stretch up. Arch back a little bit. Exhale, come forward. Lift the head, jump back. Calm down. And up. And back, down dog. Left leg up in the air. Swing it up. Crescent pose. Then keep the back foot, the right foot down, knee out. Come on up, into the balance. If the arms in front of you is annoying, bring the arms behind you. That works. Don't let anything distract your attention. Uh-oh. Hands down, leg up. You guys are so quiet all of a sudden. You had so much energy before. Right arm up in the air this time, left hand or fingers stay down. Roll all the way open or as much as you can. The more you can roll the hip open, the better. Okay, bring it down. Feet together, hands down. Arms up in the air, bend the legs, chair pose. Feet are together, knees are together, more or less. You can sink down a little more, Sheila. Keep going. That's not it. Keep going. Oh, that's much better. Hands to the floor, straighten the legs. Lift the head, jump back or step back. Stay up, don't come down yet. Now listen very carefully. Slowly come down into the chaturanga, the 2-inch push-up. When you get close, arch up into the up dog. Just wanted to see if you were listening, that's all. And then come back down into the chaturanga. Wait, wait. Ah. So you're here, and then you come back down. And then you push back up, up dog. And then you come back down. Where are you going? And then you arch up, up dog. And then you push back down, dog. Whee! Right leg up in the air. Keep the right leg where it is. Raise the left hand off the floor, in front of you or behind you, to the side. This doesn't have to last long. I'm sure you're happy about it. Let's try the other side. Bring it down. Left leg up in the air, right hand off the floor. You can adjust it any way you need to, including not doing it. And bring it down, everything. Jump both feet up to the hands. Chair pose, arms up, legs bent.
GP, are you with me?
And bring the hands down, straighten the legs. Roll all the way up, stretch up. Arch back a little bit if you can. And exhale, come all the way forward. And just hang down here, roll the weight toward the balls of the feet. If you want, you can interlock the hands behind your back and drop them over your head. You don't want to, just hang down. More warm-up, yoga style, when we return. Stay with it. Yeah, good music today. Guess what? We're back. Roll all the way up. Stretch up. You can't dance to this, you can't dance. Exhale and come all the way forward. Lift the head, jump back or step back. And come down. And push up with an inhale. Exhale yourself back into the downward facing dog. Stay here, sink the chest. Fingers are spread wide apart, palms are flat. Yeah. Raise the right leg up in the air. Swing the foot up into a crescent pose. Turn the back foot, the left foot flat down. Turn to the side into a warrior pose. Make sure you bend the right leg and more or less into a right angle. Left leg straight. Look out over the right fingertip. Slide the left hand down the left leg as far as you can, stretching back with the right arm. Turn the right palm down, roll the right ribs and shoulder open, look up. From there, if you want a little bit more, bend the right leg a little more. And bring the right hand down to the floor, flat down to the inside of the right foot, left arm straight up in the air, or straight over your head. Keep rolling the left ribs open. Reach underneath the right leg with the right arm if you can. Grab the left hand or wrist or fingers behind your back. If that's too much for you, just drop the left arm behind you and keep the right hand on the floor. Okay, bring the hands to the floor, step the foot back. Come all the way down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, downward dog. Left leg up in the air. The nightmare continues to unfold for you. Swing it up. Crescent pose first. You could say I lost my belief in the Holy Church. You could say I lost my sense of direction. And then turn the right foot flat into the warrior, other side. Sink down into it. Kind of lift the chest, center of the chest, and breathe. Even though your thigh hurts, you're sweating, you're irritable, underneath, you're just silently witnessing very calmly in an ideal world. Breathe. Slide the right hand down the back leg. In this case, the right one. Reach back. Again, try as much as you can to roll the left ribs open. Straighten the arm. Bring the left hand down to the floor, flat down to the inside of the foot. Right arm straight up in the air. Rolling the ribs open. Okay, reach underneath, grab the right fingers or hand or wrist. The more you can roll the right chest open, the better. What happened? All right, bring the hands down. Step the foot back. Come down. Arch up. Stay here in the up dog. Reassess your desire to do yoga. And then push back into the downward facing dog. Jump the feet up to the hands, sit down. Turn to the side again. Let's do the other one. This one's fun. You bring the hands back behind you about a foot or so. Fingers are pointing toward the feet. If you can push the feet flat, that's good. If not, to stay on the heels, but push the hips up, chest up, head back. Reverse slant pose. And then sit down. Turn the other way on your mat. Cross the legs, bring the hands down, flat down in front of the bent knees, lean forward, jump back. Right in the wall. Arch up. And push back. Down, down. Let it not to fall. 13-month-old baby. Right leg in the air. Swing the foot up. Crescent pose. Once you're there, if you can bring the arms out wide and drop the head back. If it's too religious for you, you can keep the arms straight up. And then bring the hands together over your head. Slowly hook the left elbow over the front leg. Come into a prayer-style twist. If that doesn't work for you and it's too intense, you can bring the left hand to the floor, right arm up in the air. If you're doing the one hand down, one arm up, you can bring the left hand to the inside of the foot. That makes it a little easier. Really extend up with the right fingertip. But straighten the back leg no matter what variation you are doing. If there's some other variation you'd like to do, help yourself. Michelle's always good for an advanced variation. He's okay. Hands down to the floor. Step the foot back. Come down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, downward dog. Ah, left leg up in the air. Swing it up, no time to waste. Crescent pose. Again, if you can. Bring the arms out wide. If you can't, don't worry about it. And bring the palms together above you and hook the right elbow over the left leg, the front leg. Twist open the chest. Bring the hands down. Sink all the way down toward the floor. We'll cool down when we come back. Arch up. Just stay here in the up dog. Stay tuned to Oxygen Media. And we're back for a little cool down. So bring the soles of the feet together. Pull them close in. You can grab the feet if you want with the hands. Try to keep the back flat for as long as you can. Extend out and then down. It's called Baddha Konasana or cobbler pose. If you hold it for a while, even if you hold it for a second, you'll probably feel something in the hips or thighs or low back. This is what's supposed to happen. Just hang out here and breathe slow and deep. If you're just watching, it doesn't look like there's much happening, but if you're doing it, you know there is. Try to relax while you're here. Use the breath to help you do that. Long, slow, deep breath. Let Now, some variations of this pose, you don't come down at all. You just stay sitting up and pushing the knees down. That's another way to work it. Or you don't go down all the way. You try to keep the back flat. But for this one, for most people, if you just let the back round and come forward, that's good enough. A little bit more, stay here, breathe. I always hear the same comment, I'm too stiff to do yoga. But that's the wrong idea. You do yoga to become flexible. If you start out flexible, then what's the point? So if your knees are way up in the air and you barely come forward, so what? As long as you're getting a little stretch, you are doing it. Correctly. How's that? All right. Slowly come up. I'm going to try one called the Happy Cow, completely misnamed. Bring the right knee over the left one, like so. Much as you can. The feet are, you're not sitting on the feet, they're out a little ways from the butt. Now if this top knee is up like this, that just means your hips are tight and you have mental problems. Don't let that bother you, this will fix it. So once you're here, this is the cow part, the happy part is
when you come forward, out the way.
Now if you don't feel anything in the outer thigh or the back of the butt or right there in the femur joint, the hip joint, then something's wrong. You can raise your hand and I can help you.
There's tears in these eyes. Not happy ever after. And I thought it was plain to see. And I thought the whole world could be that.
Don't bounce while you're here. Just slow, steady pressure.
You could say that I'm living in a pipe dream. It's just looking back. Things I never what they seem. And I hope I can safely say
so, sit up slowly. There's two ways to get out of this, the normal, boring way or the exciting, fun way. The fun way is you spin out and go over to the other side. Doesn't always work out, but doesn't matter. Calm down. What's happening?
So don't ask me why. It was plain to see, and I thought
Okay, come on up. Bring the left foot straight out in front of you, left leg out in front of you, rather. Bend the right leg. Just bring the sole of the right foot to the inside of the left thigh. You can shift around to your, got a little leverage and you're comfortable. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, come down. Grab whatever you can. Breathe slow and deep. Sing along. Sensation is happening in the straight leg or low back, rather than resisting it and fighting it and trying to change it, just see if you can welcome it, allow it, kind of melt into it. Really bring your mind there, your presence to it. And in so doing, it will shift, it will transform. Or it would if we held it long enough, which we're not going to. So come on up. Other side, same thing. Come on down. Your neck by dropping the chin down toward the chest. Slowly come up. Just relax in a sitting position. We'll do some meditation when we return. You're watching Inhale. And we're back for the relaxation part of the class. You're just lying flat on your back, arms down by your sides, palms turned up in a receptive gesture, whether it's authentic or not. Face is relaxed. Move the shoulders away from the ears so your neck is long and spacious. Next time you exhale, squeeze all the air out. At the bottom of the exhale, just squeeze all the air out of you, empty completely. Hold it out for a moment. And then inhale very deeply. Pull a deep inhale. Starting in the lower abdomen, it rolls all the way to the very top of the lungs. Hold the breath for a second. And let it go. One more time. Squeeze the air out first. Then inhale very deep through the nose. abdomen, lower ribs, mid ribs, all the way to the very top of the lungs. Hold it a little bit longer this time, we'll hold it. And exhale. And just drop everything. Forget the past, which is everything before this moment, this moment, this moment, this moment. It's all past. By the time you cognize the present, it's past. And whatever you imagine of the future, your imagining comes from a projection in the past. Otherwise, you couldn't conceive of it. So just remain in the presence of this moment, not grasping, not seeking. Just open. Very slowly, start to bring your attention back a little bit. You can wiggle the fingers or toes. Allow the eyes to remain closed. And roll slowly at your leisure to one side. And with the eyes still closed, gently float yourself up into a comfortable sitting position. Spine is straight, but you're relaxed. All the muscles around the spine are soft and open. And just sit relaxed and open.